might look healthy, but if you measure that child, he didn't grow to the size that he should have grown. And I'm sorry I didn't have a good picture of a girl to show you there, and have all girls here, but I wanted to really demonstrate some pictures. That little child didn't grow as she should grow. So that child is not as at the height that they should be that would demonstrate that they can grow well. That child also has anemia and has a lot of consequences related to that, and I'll talk about that in a minute. And we don't always think about obesity as a problem of malnutrition, but it is also a problem. So if we look a little bit about the magnitude of these problems around the world, I'm not going to spend too much time on this, but if you look at that problem of anemia, which we don't necessarily see, we call it hidden hunger, it's not necessarily visible, and you know that that child has it, but if you look in Africa, particularly across sub-Saharan Africa, 68% of children, according to these data from 2013, may suffer from anemia. 57% of pregnant women. 79% of children in South Asia are estimated to be zinc deficient, which is another essential mineral that we get from the foods that we eat across Latin America as well. And as you can see, there's also some regions of the world where we don't have so much data, so we don't know the extent to which that's a problem. But this isn't a problem that only affects the poor. Clearly, if you've got 79% of the population, 79% of the population aren't necessarily poor, expecting beyond just the people who are poor. And the other problem we talked about, that's actually the wrong term there. It's estimated that 153 million children around the world haven't grown to the height that they should have grown if they had been malnourished. And if you look at the research and you understand the problems of nutrition, a lot of that has to do with their exposure to infection, their inability to use it,